A few days ago, I shared a screenshot of my personal Notion dashboard and got some questions on the icons. Where did I get them? How do we set these up? So I wanted to walk through how to use a tool called Streamline HQ, not a sponsor, just a big fan, to walk through not only how to customize our icons, but some best practices to organize them for later, choosing colors that match and that create a set of icons that you can use for different databases and different page types. And also doing just a quick review on the things that you can get in the free version of Streamline HQ versus the paid version. I'm on the paid version and you get some extra benefits and customizations. So just want to walk through those things. So you can see here, we've got different database views, everything from daily planners to more project task related databases, content, and everything in between. If I open up the databases page, this is where all these like original databases live. So you can see generally blue is personal, the mango red orange is work related, green is content and information, knowledge, that stuff. And then anything like meeting notes, proposals, things like that are that yellow. Just as an example to get some ideas going on, if you are building a template or your own workspace and you've got multiple databases, just to get a sense of using those icons as visual markers to be able to navigate more easily within your workspace. So next area we're gonna go to is Streamline. So this is, if I go into the homepage, you can see here there's different libraries of assets, everything from icons, illustrations, emojis, and some other stuff. We're gonna focus in on icons, and there's actually quite a bit you can grab within the free version without having an account in Streamline. So for example, if I grab any one of these icons and I wanna download this home icon, you are limited to PNG files. So to just do a quick comparison between PNG and SVG, PNG is essentially an image file. So you grab it, it's got a transparent background so you don't have that white canvas that it's saved on, but you can't really do much when it comes to editing. SVG is essentially a vector graphic. So you can take that into Figma or another or Adobe Illustrator and make some changes to that file, keep it as a vector, and then you have the option to save it as an image file or even upload the SVG to Notion as a page icon. So you just get more customization there when you get the SVG, but for a lot of cases, PNG is more than fine. So if you go into the settings on the right, you can adjust the size of the image. So if I wanna say this is gonna be 250 pixels and then also adjust the stroke, which is basically the thickness of the icon. So we'll make that a little bit bigger, let's say 10. You can see here that's adjusting the preview. And then when we click download, it's going to download that PNG file and save it to your downloads. And then from there, you could go back into your database. And I'm going to use an old template and do some revisions on this. So we're using a Goals Hub template. I'm going to upload that file. So we're going to go to downloads. And we've got that PNG. You can see here that uploads. And if based on that pixel size, it's not really blurry or pixelated at any point. So we're going to actually turn this into light mode. Definitely recommend just comparing dark and light mode, and then also on desktop and mobile, just to get a sense of how the icons are looking before you set up all your icons, download them, and then realize. Also choosing this template because it's got several different databases. So looking at a color coding system for each database type, just to be able to differentiate. So we've got that icon in. What I'd like to do next is we're gonna go back to Streamline, and then I'm gonna head to the Flex family and specifically Flex Gradient. One of the cool things about this one is you could apply multiple colors, create your own gradient. So you can get pretty customized with how the icons are looking and feeling and just making it feel really custom. So from here, what we're gonna do next is actually, I'm gonna jump into Pinterest just to get some inspiration when it comes to color gradients. Because if you've played around with this at any point and we start messing around with our color picker here, for whatever reason, when we do this manually, it doesn't quite ever look how it's supposed to. So what we wanna do is avoid all that testing, go into Pinterest, grab a specific hex codes for colors, save them, and then that way we've got a strategy for what this color system is gonna look like. We're gonna go by colors. So let's say we search for color gradient, UI icon, and then we're gonna go with orange. And we're specifically looking for one that has two colors in the gradient. So if we go to this one, we could see here it's giving us the code for this light yellow and then the slightly darker orange color, and we can use this to demo here. So I'm going to grab these colors, the 6-digit color code for each, and then we're going to plug this into Streamline to start setting up our icon set. So back in Streamline, just to get into some differences between the free and paid version, if we go into this navigation menu and click download, you'll see this pop up saying it's a low quality image download. So we're capped at the pixel size, and then we are not able to download an SVG or some other file types. So what we're gonna do is log in, see what it looks like to customize an SVG icon and get that into Notion. Now that I'm logged in, we're gonna head to the Flex family and specifically Flex Gradient. And here, what we're gonna do is search for home. It's a home icon. We're gonna go with this one up here, and we're gonna set this to SVG, and the size of SVGs don't need to be nearly as large as PNG files, but I do like to see them in preview when I'm looking for them in files, so that's why they're slightly larger than they need to be, but this could be like 50 pixels or even smaller because they're vectors. So if we head to colors, what we're gonna do is grab the colors that we chose from that Pinterest inspiration image. So I'm gonna grab that first one and then paste that here, just make sure that looks correct. Another thing you can do is save this color. So highly recommend doing this. This is gonna add it to your color library. So whether you're making dashboards for your own workspace or templates for other users, you can like quickly revisit this and pair colors, especially if you're using the gradient option. Then the next one, I'm going to click in the second swatch and drop in that second hex code. It's here, so we've got that orange. Save this one as well. So we've got that gradient here. You want to just check that typically the lighter color is at the top of the icon or somewhere at the top, and then the darker one is at the bottom, just to mimic how light works. So now that we've got that icon, we're going to download this here. This is going to go to our downloads, and then we're going to head back to our template. We're going to click in this page icon, click custom, and then add this icon here. So now we've got our new icon, and then you'll see here, it's also showing up here. So as you've got, you can open your sidebar and see specific databases. If I expand this, you'll also see views of databases and then also the original databases. One thing we're gonna do next, this is something that Notion creators rarely do, but it's actually really helpful, especially if you're making multiple templates, is creating a library of icons. So we're going to walk through how to do that, some ways to quickly revisit icons that you've saved, and if you want to make any changes, the best way to do that as easily as possible. So we're going to open the sidebar, and then we're going to create a new page in this general team space called Icon Library. We're gonna make this a database, which is now referred to as a table, even though Notion now calls them both. So we're gonna say new table, and we're going to set this first view as a gallery. Cool, so we've got our gallery. And then from here, we're gonna open a page to set up a few additional properties, specifically a URL. So if we've got where the icon lives, let's add file and media property here. We're going to add the actual file, and then we'll keep tags and maybe add that in over time. So I'm going to label this one home, and in files and media, I'm going to upload the SVG that we just grabbed here. So we're going to add that in here, and now we've got that SVG file. And then if I go back into the home page, we're going to go to layout and then show this as files and media. And we're gonna say fit image. So now we've got our icon. Let's make these a little bit smaller because we'll likely have many different icons. And we can populate this with multiple icons. One other thing I'd suggest is grouping if you're creating multiple templates. Let's say we open this and we create a multi-select. Call this template. We're gonna say because this is part of the goals hub, I'm gonna create that one, and then maybe we're creating a habit tracker. So we've got templates that this icon is a part of. We'll just say it's only on the goals hub for now, so that we could then group this gallery by template. And then now we have quick access to our icon library. One other step I'd take, because we created that URL property, is if we go back to Streamline, we can add this to a collection in Streamline. I think this is also might be if we are on the paid plan, we're going to create a new collection and call this Goals Hub and then save. So the next thing we're going to do is, because we've got that URL property, we're going to use this to link to the favorites in Streamline. So if I'm back in the icon library, where if we click share and copy this link, it's going to grab a link to the individual icon. But I've noticed that there's kind of some issues here where it doesn't quite save the color system, and it's a little clunky with making some edits. So instead of doing that, what we're going to do is save this icon to a, in this case, the Goals Hub collection. And if we were to go back into icons and then go to favorites and then Goals Hub, now we've got the link to that icon, and then we can make some changes here if we want to reuse it, if we want to change the color system or add it to a different one. So if we go into Goals Hub and this link, we're going to copy this link here and then head to the new icon library database and click paste, so that now if I open this up, it's going to open directly to that icon. As we're creating multiple libraries, this is going to be super useful just to keep track of all your icons and not have to reinvent the wheel or recreate them every time you're creating a new template, or if you're working with clients, creating a new icon set for every client. And we'll notice that we're likely reusing a lot of the same icons, maybe tweaking them, and in which case, if we wanted to create a variation of this one, so let's say for a habit tracker, we want to go back into Pinterest. We're going to look for blue icon gradient. Let's see what we find here. Let's say we choose this one here. We're going to grab the hex codes for this one, top color and the bottom color. And I'm just jotting down the 9-digit code so we can use that in Streamline. So we'll go back in here. We're in icons, and now I'm going to go to color editor, copy and paste that first color, save that one, and then copy and paste the second color. Oh, let me highlight the second color first. And now we've got our new icon, and we're going to download this one as an SVG. Just make this slightly larger. And click download. Let's head back into home. What we're going to do is actually duplicate this one, and we're going to leave the same name, home, but we're going to make this for the habit tracker instead, and we're going to replace that previous one with the new icon. So we're going to delete this one, go to upload, grab that blue one, and now we've got our new home icon for the habit tracker. And then when we're grouping these, we're going to turn off or just the order of this so that we've got Goals Hub first, habit tracker second, things like that. So what happens if we try to save these icons in Notion and then grab a link to that image and use that for our icons? So want to test this out and see if it works. So we're going to back into our home icon, and what we're going to do is drag and drop the icon from our computer. So we're going to go in here, drag and drop this image in here. And you'll notice once we have this in, if I click in this and I head to the menu at the top, we could view original, which has a link attached to it. Meaning if I click on view original, this is going to open an image file that's saved in Notion's server. And then if I go back into Notion, let's see if this works and if this allows me to add an icon for this page. So instead of adding a file, we're going to add a link. So I'm going to copy the link that we just created. This is the Notion file here, and then click submit. And then now we've got that file pulling in directly from our Notion database. So one of the benefits here is if I go back into the icon library, if we turn on the properties, let's turn on the URL and maybe files and media, we don't need that one. But let's say instead of linking to Streamline, what we're doing is grabbing the link to the image file that we added below. So we've got this file from Notion.svg. So now that we've got this icon link, I'm gonna click copy to clipboard. And if we wanna change the icon of a page, I can click custom, paste that link, and have it show up as an icon. Let's try that in the goal sub template. We're going to go to goals hub, and let's say we want to update the areas database. We're going to click custom, paste that link, press submit, and then now we've got our icon. So as a level up to the icon library, not only can we drop those icons in here, but we also have the option to, instead of linking to an external icon library or icon set, you could drop the image into the Notion page. That's going to create a Notion link. You can drop that link in the URL, make the URL visible, and then that way when we open here and click copy, then we can paste that icon into the page that you're updating or the database. So wanted to add that and experiment on the fly live, but it does seem to work. If you're thinking of building out a full icon set, that's probably the way to go. And I would just test if you're using PNGs or SVGs, testing on a few icons just to make sure that you can grab the link, paste it, and make sure that it works in your template or in your workspace. I hope that's helpful. And let me know in the comments if you're creating your own icon set or if you've got any recommendations on saving as PNG or SVG. Definitely curious to hear how you're approaching it. And also let me know if this is something that you're interested in diving deeper on in terms of customizing your workspace or if you're creating templates, just to get a sense of how to build these templates and systems with a little bit more character. See you in the next video.